Bonjour à tous. Good morning to all. And today we are going to see about the letter and comprehension écrit and la rédaction. So letter it means letter writing and comprehension écrit it's written comprehension and la rédaction it means a essay. So before that we will recall once our previous video. So our previous video is about the content is leprono-anthrocative, leprono-demonstrative, and leprono-direct and leprono-indirect only. So what is prono-anthrocative? Prono-anthrocative means interrogative pronoun. So it is used to ask a question about a person, animal, or thing. So it means which one or which ones. So what are the prono-anthrocative? Locale, it is used for the masculine singular, and locale, it is used for the feminine singular, and locale, it is used for the masculine plural, and locale, it is used for the feminine plural. So it means which one or which ones, and it is used to ask a question while avoiding the repetition. And this is all about the prono anthrocative. And second content is le prono demonstrative. Prono demonstrative means it's a demonstrative pronoun. So these pronouns are replace a specific nouns that was mentioned previously. So what are demonstrative pronoun? Salut, sal, so, and sal. So what is the meaning of salut? This one or that one. And sal also these one or that one, and sir these one or those. So salut it is used for the masculine singular, and sal it is used for the feminine singular, and sir it is used for the masculine plural, and sal it is used for the feminine plural. And move to the third content. Third content is leprono. Leprono can be classified into two types. One is direct object pronoun, another one is indirect object pronoun. So what is direct object pronoun? So direct object pronoun replaces a direct object complement. It is used for the things only. So what are the direct object pronouns? Me, te, le, ella, nous, vous, les. These are the direct object pronoun. Let's move to the indirect object pronoun. So what are the indirect object pronoun? It replaces a person's name. And answer the question is who. So it is used for the person only. And what are the indirect object pronoun? Me, te, lui, nous, vous, and leur. These are all indirect object pronoun. So this is all about our previous video. Let's move to the today's video. It's all about the letter writing, written comprehension, and the essay, which is based on the lesson 3. So today's title, La Lettre, Comprehension écrit, and La Rédaction. Let's move to the letter. So vous avez écrivez une lettre à votre ami pour lui dire que vous avez rencontré un camarade de classe après lui de 15 ans. So you have to find the letter whether it is a formal or informal. So here you have to write to your friends only, no? So for that, this is the informal letter only. So write your letter to your friend and to tell him that you have a met a classmate after 15 years. So you're going to speak about that classmate only. And first is place and date, that is Chennai, and the date is Le 4 mars, the meal when, that is 2020. And your salutation is Shar, and the name of the person is Shiva. So my dear Shiva, or dear Shiva, comment vas-tu? So how are you? And nous allons bien ici et nous espérons que tout le monde va bien chez toi aussi also. It means we are fine here and we hope everyone at home is fine too. So here the verb is aller verb, that is to go, and next espero means to hope. Esper verb, it's a to hope. and Jaspis Talmo Herre, the partage when Mavalius Newell a Jevata la Rencontre. So it means I'm so excited to share some wonderful news and I want to tell you. And next paragraph, this is all about the opening paragraph. And next is, what is the purpose of the letter? Tuta Suveni, the notre comrade Marie. So do you remember our friend Marie? Here the souvenir verb. Souvenir verb means to remember. And the friend name is what? Marie. And elle étudiait avec nous à l'école. So she was studying with us at the school. And here, je suis allé à une soirée et j'ai rencontré une très belle dame. So yesterday I went to a party and I met a very beautiful lady. And next, on lui a présenté et ensuite je réalisé que c'était Marie. So I was introduced to her and then realized that it was Marie. And je la rencontré après 15 ans. So I met her after 15 years only. Maintenant, now, elle vit en Australie et elle y fait ses études. And now she lives in Australia and she is doing her studies there one. Next, elle était si heureux de me rencontrer et elle veut rencontrer tous les camarades the class, and she was happy to meet me and she wants to meet all her classmates. And pouvons-nous organiser un rendez-vous? So can we arrange a appointment? And elle sera en non pour deux semaines, and she will be in India for 2 weeks. And réponds-moi immédiatement, it means reply immediately. And essayez de contacter nos amis et nous reverrons bientôt. So try to contact our friends and we will meet again soon. And the expression is au revoir and à bientôt. It's a goodbye and see you soon. Amicalement, it's your friendly, write your name. So this is all about your letter. So you have to write a letter to your friend. It's all about your classmate only. You met her after 15 years. So her name is what? Marie. And they are deciding. They want to decide. They want to meet all the classmates. She want to meet all the classmates. So she is. They are going to arrange an appointment for these 2 weeks only. Why? Because she will be in India for 2 weeks only. For that, they are arranging on meeting. And this is all about our letter. Let's move to the text feature in this letter. So address is Chennai, Le 4 mars, the mid van. That is address and the date. And the salutation is Shar Shiva, that is dear Shiva. And the opening paragraph is come over to you, nous allons bien ici. So how are you? We are fine. And these are the opening paragraph. And final paragraph is répondez-moi immédiatement. It's a replay immediately. And the closing expression is au revoir, à bientôt. It means goodbye, see you soon. And farewell, it's amicalement. It means amicalement means it's yours friendly. Let's move to the second content. Second content is the compréhension écrite. So compréhension écrite, lisez le passage sous vous et répondez à question. So read the passage and answer the question. So Charles et Jean ont pris l'autobus pour aller à Versailles. So Charles and Jean, as 2 persons, took the bus to the Versailles. And les deux garçons ont trouvé des places sur la plateforme à l'arrière de l'autobus, d'où ils ont regardé avec l'intérêt les rues animées de la vie. It means the 2 boys found the seat on the platform at the back of the bus. From they looked with the interest at the busy street in the city. And next, après winner, they voyage ils arrivent à leur destination et descendent de l'autobus à l'entrée du château. So after an hour of travel, they arrive at their destination and get off the bus at the entrance of the castle. And the key a sad statue. So who is that statue? Demon Charles. So ask Charles. Next, il indique de la main le grand statue vin home monte à cheval. So it indicate with his hand the large statue of the man mounted in a horseback. It's Louis Cartos, that is Louis XIV. Au commencement de son régime, il a demeuré à Paris, au Louvre, mais à ses ordres, une armée d'hommes a travaillé pour transformer la modeste maison de campagne qui a existé ici dans le vaste château que nous allons visiter après le déjeuner. So it means, at the beginning of his region, he stayed in Paris at the Louvre, it's one of the museum in France, and but at his command an army of horses worked to transform the modest country house that excited here in the vast castle that we will visit after the lunch. So déjeuner means what? Lunch. And il y a un restaurant près du château. So there is a restaurant near the castle. And vous les repas sont bons et à le prix sont très raisonnables. It means unreasonable. And there is a one restaurant and the price also good and reasonable. So this is all about this paragraph. Charles and Jean, they took a autobus to Versailles. Versailles is one of the city in France, and they found a seat in the platform of the back, at the back of the bus. From they looked with the interest at the busy street in the city. After an hour, they traveled to their destination and get off their bus. At the entrance of the castle, there is a statue. Charles is asking, and the statue name is Louis Cartos, a man mounted in the horseback. That is the name of that statue, that is Louis Cartos. So at the this thing, they are found one restaurant, it's near to the castle, and the price were reasonable. This is all about this paragraph. Let's see the question. Charles et Jean, vous vont-ils? So Charles and Jean, where do they go? So Charles et Jean vont à Versailles. So Charles and Jean go to the Versailles. And second, vous vont-ils trouver des places? So where did they find the places? Ils ont trouvé des places sur plateforme à l'arrière de l'autobus. So they found a seats on the platform at the back of the seats. And third one is, qu'est-ce qu'ils vont regarder avec intérêt? So what did they look at with their interest? So ils ont regardé avec intérêt les rues animées de la vie. It means they looked with the interest at the bustling street in the city. And fourth one is, qu'est-ce qu'ils vont voir à l'entrée du château? So what did they see at the entrance of the castle? À l'entrée du château, at the entrance of the castle, ils ont vu la statue du roi Louis XIV. So they saw a statue of king, that is Louis XIV. And fifth, vous y allez restaurant. So where is the restaurant? It's near to that castle only, right? So le restaurant est près du château. And sixth one, comment sont les repas au restaurant? So how are the meals in the restaurant? And les repas sont bons et les prix sont raisonnables au restaurant. So it means the meals are good and the prices are reasonable in the restaurant. So this is all about the comprehension écrit, that is written comprehension. let us move to the third one, that is redaxio. Redaxio means that is essay only. So your redaxio, it's all about shopping mall. So let's see the topic. Manisha fait du shopping dans une grande surface of Paris. So Manisha goes for a shopping in a hypermarket in Paris, and elle décrit son experience inoubliable. It means she describes her memorable experience. So this is the shopping mall, that is La Galerie Lafayette. So La Galerie Lafayette, it's one of the most popular and distinguished shopping in center in Paris, and it is situated in Paris also. And this is the La Galerie Lafayette. So we are going to see about this shopping mall only. So your resume, that is summary, is introduction, that is introduction, what you are going to introduce in this paragraph. And second, La Galerie Lafayette, it's a shopping mall. And third, it's a conclusion, it's a conclusion only. Let's see the introduction, introduction. So dans ce petit paragraph, je vais partager mon expérience inoubliable à la Galerie Lafayette. So in this small paragraph, I am going to share my memorable experience at Lafayette Gallery. And La Galerie Lafayette, cette une grande surface à Paris, c'est le grand magasin qui ne dort jamais. So the Lafayette Gallery is a hypermarket in Paris, and this is a superstore that never sleeps. And cette grande surface a une superficie à 17,000, that is millimeter, une large gamme de marque est disponible dans le magasin pour tous les budgets du prêt à porter à l'autre couture. So this hypermarket has an area of 70,000 square meter and a wide range of brands in available in the store for all the budgets, from ready to wear and to hot culture. And next, on it through breaker tooth. So it means this, there is almost everything. And some magasin organise the défilé the more the hebdomadaire. So this store organize weekly fashion shows and set win grand attraction pour les visiteurs. So it is a great attraction for the visitors. And moi, je suis allé pour acheter une robe, and I went to buy a dress, but I totally forgot about that. Mais je l'ai complètement oublié grâce à ce défilé de mode. So thanks to this fashion show, it was remarkable. C'était exceptional, it means it was remarkable. And quelle mode, what a fashion. And quelle haute couture, and what a haute couture. And cette une expérience que je n'ai pas jamais oublié. So it is an experience that I can never forget. And conclusion is set an endroit. So it's a place, endroit, sir. It is a must see place. Absolument visiter quand on est à Paris. So when you are in Paris, il ne faut pas oublier d'apprécier son dôme et son balcon. So above all, one should not forget to enjoy its dome and its balcony. So this is all about this paragraph, that is redaction, La Galerie Lafayette. So this is all about our today's video, that is letter writing. So you have to write your letter to your friend and to tell him that you have met a classmate after 15 years. And this is all about the letter. And the comprehension, agree they are visiting somewhere. And third one is Manisha goes for shopping in a hypermarket in Paris, and she describes her memorable moments. So this is all about today's video, and I hope you are all understand this thing. And thank you. मैसी।